Yeah, we're all through, Mike. This is Match Game 74, production number 0185. Air date to be announced, VT Yard 32974. Take one.
Get ready to match the stars. Alan Ludden. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Joyce Boulevard. Richard Dawson. And Barry Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
There's a microphone here somewhere. You rascal.
Thanks, I needed that.
I need it. Oh, how can I do the show without a microphone?
How are you, honey?
Very well,
I missed
thank
you.
Thank you. Mm. How have you been?
Yes, rest
you
of
Betty's right.
Dismissed.
You really are a dirty old man.
That's true.
Yeah.
D-O-M for short.
Yeah.
What it's... happened? You said you'd call. I waited in all day.
That's enough of that.
Well, it's the
His
truth.
Reputation is
no,
bad enough.
Fanny, kiss me. See?
Do you know that when Betty's sitting there?
Have you had any of the
yes.
diseases on this list?
Let's welcome our two players here, Mary Duncan and Laurie Healy. Mary's our current champ with a total of $350, and we started this game last time out, and Laurie had her go at it, and she didn't score any matches at all, and we've got a question for you in round one, and if you're ready, ladies, we'll get to that right after we do a little business with all of you around America.
Bad news.
All right, now, here we go.
I'll push a button,
and away we go. We've got this question for you, Mary. See you later. We were just horsing around during the break there.
You go back to Boston on the weeks
yes,
off.
Yes, I do. Let me see
I
what this
I think you better hurry.
Brian said...
You look a little flustered.
Boy,
there.
I was on a wild new airline. During the flight, the first class passengers are allowed to blank the coach passengers. That's what Brian said. He was on this wild airline. I'm out of breath.
At your age, you should be out of breath, sweetheart.
During the flight, the first class passengers are allowed to blank the coach passengers. All right, bottom tier is ready. Well, except for Fanny. You're thinking too hard, Fanny. Just trust your first judgment, honey.
The first
time right.
was to leave.
Oh.
Fanny, today, dear, today.
I know.
It isn't a 24-hour show. It's just a half-hour show, darling.
Now we're ready to get an answer from Mary Duncan. Brian said, boy, I was on a wild new airline. During the flight, the first-class passengers are allowed to blank the coach passengers.
Play around with them?
Play around with them. I'll let the judge interpret that any way he wants. He's over there. He's already talking to the guy in the control room. It's going to be a decision involving three people there. Okay, play around is our answer. Alan, what's yours?
It's going to be a decision involving four people.
Yeah.
I said sleep with.
No match?
Well, it all depends on how you sleep. The
yes, right. Okay.
Turn on this man. He's married to Betty White.
Well, what did you say about those passengers?
Well, I sort of said play around with. I said streak.
Streak with.
Sure, there you go.
All right, Charles.
Okay. I'm afraid I'm with these other two bananas I live with. I said stone.
Stone? Well, they throw stones at them.
Stone.
The first class passengers are allowed two, and she said play around the coach passengers. What do you say, Joyce?
Britt, were you on that same flight I was?
Uh-huh.
Where I said that
Streak.
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
He
streaked.
Took
him
out. He did it. Yeah.
Right down in the raw and bing, up and down the aisle two times.
We gotta move on. I've got a plane to catch.
Oh, all right. Richard.
I happen to know the first class passengers are allowed to mug
the mugger. First passengers. All right. Bing. Okay, Fanny, we're up to you.
First of all, people were hollering at me, and I was very pressured, and I get very upset. And I was a Girl Scout, and I'm a very sweet person, and I didn't know what to write, so I wrote pickle.
Gene, I think now is the time on the air to point out that Fanny has beautiful skin, doesn't
she? Yes. She does have beautiful skin.
Beautiful skin.
She has many other terrific qualities. All right, that's the end of round one. And now we'll go to round two. And Laurie, would you please make a selection?
I'll try B. Again.
You want B. All right. Everybody plays because no one matched Laurie in the first time.
Oh, really?
All the little people in the valley were mad at the jolly green giant. So they put a porcupine in his blank.
Honey, could you swing that in ragtime?
Right. All the little people in the valley were mad at the jolly green giant, so they put a porcupine in his blank.
I got you.
Okay. Finished here.
I'm one of the more terrific players.
Lower tier is ready, upper tier.
Well, just hold on a minute. They write and I print.
Okay.
I went to private school.
It doesn't show.
All right, Laurie Healy. All the little people in the valley were mad at the jolly green giant, so they put a porcupine in his...
bed.
In his bed. His bed. He said bed. If I were playing, I would have said shoe for some reason. What
you
did you say?
Shoe?
I would have said shoe because...
You're as dumb as Alan
Ludden. Shoe must be this big.
Yeah, well, I think of a big giant.
Yeah, a big man.
Who wears shorts.
Okay.
But I didn't get anything.
Porcupine in his shorts there. Bed is the answer she's looking for, Brett.
I'll tell you exactly where they put that porcupine, my darling. They put it in his vegetable patch.
In his vegetable patch.
You bet your old-fashioned tintype, my
Thank
love.
You, Tallulah. Now, Charles.
I said Tallulah. Well, no matter. In a peapod.
In a peapod. Well, that didn't hurt. What do you say?
For Pete's sakes, if I was one of them little folks, I'd put the porcupine in his bed.
In his bed. Okay. That would hurt. Richard?
I happen to know they put a porcupine in his pants.
That would hurt, too.
No,
Fanny,
thank you. We're
what do the little people do to the jolly green giant?
My grandmother was a member of the Eastern Star for a long time. I put green suit.
In his green suit.
You know, his
Now
his
that's as bad as President Arthur.
You know, you're going downhill slowly, Fanny, but it's okay. We love you anyway because you got great skin.
Thank you.
Now it's one and nothing in the middle of round two, and we've got to pause here for a little passage, and we'll be right back after something goes on here in Hollywood.
GSN presents Behind the Blank. Growing up, this radio DJ was a huge fan of the Match Game. Was it Rick Dees, Ryan Seacrest, Howard Stern, or Carson Daly? Stay tuned for the answer. You know which radio DJ was a big fan of Match Game? The correct answer is C, Howard Stern. Gene was flattered and in turn looked up to Howard. Not because Gene admired Howard's show, but because Howard was at least 6 inches taller. Stay tuned for more of that 70s hour on GSN.
Here we are. Now, Laurie scored one in her half of our second and final round. And now we point out to Mary Duncan that you must score one to stay in the game. Two, however, will win it for you. Here we go. Snow White said. All right. Which one of you seven dwarfs has been wearing my blank? She was sweet. She talked in this sweet, gentle voice. Which one of you seven dwarfs has been wearing my blank? That's what she said. She was a sweet girl, wasn't she?
She was.
Yeah, well, she was sweet as sugar.
Gene, I wish you'd loosen up a little bit, though.
I'm very tense.
She was very weird.
Charles, did you finish? There we go.
Hasn't caught on to how to play it yet.
Yes. Here we go. Mary Duncan. Snow White said, all right now. Which one of you seven dwarfs has been wearing my...
bra.
Bra? She looked too young to me to bust. It may have been a training bra for all I know. I don't know.
They call it a minus A.
A minus A? I don't know.
You know, I'm a big fan of this show. You know that, because yeah. I'm secretly in love with this lady here from the South. Of Maine.
She's
yeah, south of Maine.
But
look at her hair. So I learned, when in doubt, say...
Bra. There's a man. Score is tied. One more bra wins the game.
Oh, golly. I felt like you did that she didn't even know that she was a minus A.
Yeah.
So I said dress.
Dress. Okay. All right,
Charles.
If
you don't cut that out, you're going to get it one of these days.
What do you say?
You know the Seven Dwarfs' real names were?
No.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Think it over. Bra.
And our grateful appreciation to Laurie Healy for being with us and gracing our stage with her beauty. Good luck to you. A gift for you backstage. Many thanks for being here, Laurie.
Bye.
All right. Here we are again with the Big Money Super Match. Are you ready for it, Mary?
Ready.
Okay. We polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Blank aid. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match that. If you match the next one, it's $250 for you. If you match the bottom one, you get $100. Now, which celebrities would you like to get an assist from here?
Joyce?
Oh, good. First aid.
First aid is her answer. Another one?
Fanny.
Band-Aid. Band-Aid. What? Excuse me, one more.
Brett.
What is that?
Sugar, they just called on you.
Brett, how do you feel in that blank?
Well, I was trying to think. How about foreign aid?
Foreign aid. Just came into your head.
Just like, a little bird whispered
you know,
in my ear.
She's so pretty, though, like a southern girl. She's a little slow.
Yes, that's right. So you have Band-Aid, first aid, and foreign aid. You may choose one of those, honey. Or you can go out with me and we'll run away with the money you've got. No. Or you may give us an answer of your own. What would you like to do?
I'll say the first thing I thought of, and that's first aid.
First aid is the answer you're looking for? The one that Joyce gave you? Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where it is. First, may we see the $100 response? Hearing aid.
What? What was that?
The old people from the home were here that day. Anyway, we are looking for first aid. May we see the $250 response? Band-Aid is up there, the one that Fanny gave you. I hope that's a good sign for you, Mary. Here is your third and last shot at it. Looking for first aid? The $500 response. First aid it is, you got it. Well done, Joyce. Okay. So you've got the $500. You know that means now you play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now remember to collect. You've got to match one celebrity head to head. Which one will it be?
I think I'll pick Alan.
Since I matched him last time.
Alan who?
What did you say? What did you say?
She matched you last time.
Yeah.
And
yes,
so,
I did.
So she's choosing you, Ellen. You get ready to write.
Sweet. Something came to our floor at last.
And you face me, Mary. Here is the $5,000 question.
He can't even get it out. He's so nervous about Ellen.
No, I've got all the confidence in the world in Ellen.
All right. Just don't worry.
Buffalo blank. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but remember, your answer may be rotten. Okay, how do you fill in this blank to match Alan? Buffalo blank.
Bill.
Bill, all right. The audience thinks you've chosen a winning answer, and the moment of truth is at hand now, Mary, as we ask Alan for $5,000 to reveal his answer.
You may have saved my marriage.
Why
is
that?
You really may have saved my marriage, because if I'd blown this...
You'd never heard the end of it.
I'd have never heard the end.
You didn't blow it. You blew it!
Thank you.
audience is up to $5,950. And we'll come right back to her after this message.
Today's consolation prize is our Clairol's four-way lighted mirror, so you can make up in the light you'll be seen in. And Clairol's three-way hair setter gives your curl more choices, water mist, conditioning mist, or regular set. And mini refrigerator from Arm & Hammer Baking Soda, the nice little secret in your refrigerator, Arm & Hammer Baking Soda. And Profile, with its own great flavor from a special formula of cracked wheat and wheat germ, just right for toast. Profile, it's a matter of taste. Tell your friends they've just got time to tune in the next part of Match Game 74 in 60 seconds.
Ready for a brand new game? Let's meet a new player. Here is Kathy Wardlow. Hi, Kathy.
Hi.
Kathy will now tell us a little bit about herself. Where are you from and all that, Kathy?
I'm from North Hollywood, and I'm a mother and housewife of two adorably but naughty boys. And I'm a native of California.
Nice to have you with us, and good luck to you. Good luck to you, Mary. How do you feel?
I can't believe it.
You can't believe it?
I just can't believe it.
Better believe it. It's all there. It's yours. $5,950. Okay. Wow. Challenger, please make a selection.
I'll take A.
A, everybody plays. Arnold was so sleepy when he came to breakfast, he ate his tie and put a blank around his neck. Can you believe that? Arnold was so sleepy when he came down to breakfast, he ate his tie and put a blank around his neck.
Okay, anything you say.
Okay. All right.
Come along, sweetheart.
Charles? Go. Now, Kathy. Arnold was so sleepy when he came down to breakfast, he ate his tie and put a blank around his neck.
A towel. That's
boo!
I guess you really didn't get the idea.
I guess I did.
Towel is the answer we have to accept because that's what we heard and you said it, and there it is. Alan, she says towel.
I don't have towels for breakfast too often.
No, you don't.
But I do have pancakes.
Pancakes.
And that's what I say.
All right. Brett, what do you say?
I hate his answer. I said donut.
And stone.
Put a donut. Ate his tie and put a donut around his neck.
Bacon strip.
Bacon strip is a very good answer. The audience thinks that's the answer.
That isn't any good.
Yeah, because
either.
It's something you can put around your neck. It's elongated. What do you say?
Oh, I think that's dumb. A piece of bacon.
Piece of bacon. Arnold's so sleepy he came down to breakfast, ate his tie, and put a blank around his neck. What did he put around his neck there,
I
son?
I just happen to know he's a vegetarian.
Oh.
So he put a banana around his neck.
How'd he look?
Very, very dashing.
Okay.
You like that, sir?
What's wrong with you?
Fanny, what do you say?
Kathy, that was a hard one, wasn't it?
It
really was.
Towel.
I put newspaper.
Newspaper.
It was hard.
I hated every single answer and the question. What do you think of that?
All right, let's see what we've got for Mary. You may like this one.
Okay.
The 102-year-old man.
Oh, I love it when you act.
Jumped off Lover's Leap. Holding on to his blank. The 102-year-old man jumped off Lover's Leap, holding on to his blank. I'll show you how he did it. Well, I guess I can't do that until I hear the answers. I'll demonstrate one of those answers if they are in reason. Hold everything now until we get some light showing here. Joyce is lit and so is Fanny. We're waiting for Richard to light up. Okay, Charles, are you lit?
Yeah. You've been drinking them.
Mary Duncan. A 102-year-old man jumped off Lover's Leap holding on to his...
teeth.
Teeth. I don't know. She says teeth. What do you say?
I know, and we were so together a while ago.
Yes, you were.
It was such a nice moment.
You're drifting apart now.
We're quite a far apart because I said it was your acting that did it. I said holding on to his old lady.
On to his old lady.
Yeah, that was sweet.
That's what you do, isn't it?
Yes, what I do.
What do you say, Brett?
This old man was aflame with jealousy.
Yeah.
And he didn't want to leave anyone behind. He jumped off with his wife.
That's right. What I said. They went together.
I thought you meant his mother.
No.
You don't give this guy enough credit. It's not an old lady and it's not a wife. It's a 14-year-old girl from Kentucky, a bride.
A bride? That's why he jumped. Yeah, what
holding
do you say?
Holding onto his teeth.
Right, go.
You sure you want me to pull that out?
I was sure,
car?
I'm sure. Yeah, let's go. Out. Show and tell time. Let it all hang out. Go.
Come on.
Now, let me look at it.
It's not so bad. It's just
she says socks. What do you say, Richard?
I say leapt off holding on to his wheelchair.
Two wheelchairs. Okay, so no score here at the end of round one. And we've got a little something for you, and then come back to us. Will you do that?
Time is up. And we thank you, ladies. And we will start with round two next time we get together.
Great.
All right. Listen, I want to thank you from the bottom of my black hole heart. You're just a dandy bunch. I had a lot of fun with all of you, and I hope to see all of you.
We got the audience survey.
Yes.
82% want Brett's hair back the way it used to be, and 14 have no suggestions.
I like it the way it is. I like it, those Irish washerwoman's curls.
I know I'm going to get the lead and gone with the wind.
Right. Next time we get together, we will have these loony people with us.
Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Kelsey Brown, Richard Dawson, and Joanne Waller.
Gene Rayburn from Match Game 74. Join us next time.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Cattle Tales next over most of these CBS stations.